Young onset Parkinson's disease, its unique features and their impact on quality of life. 1. Introduction. Parkinson's disease, PD, is a neurodegenerative disorder characterized by bradykinesia associated with either one or both of rest tremor and rigidity, as well a variety of non-motor symptoms. Young onset PD, YOPD, also referred to as early onset PD, has been somewhat arbitrarily defined as PD with onset of motor symptoms between ages 21 to 40 years, 5, while onset at or before age 20 defines juvenile PD and onset after 60 defines late onset PD, LOPD. However, consensus is lacking and the reported maximal age for YOPD has varied from 40 to 55, while minimal age for late-onset PD, LOPD, has varied from 50 to 70. In this review, we specified the age ranges whenever possible when referring to specific studies. Because it affects people in the prime of their productivity, YOPD carries its own set of clinical, social, and occupational challenges. While increased genetic predisposition, slower progression, and increased risk of levodopa-related complications are well recognized in YOPD compared to LOPD, in this review we will focus on more pragmatic aspects of YOPD, namely its impact on the patient's personal, professional and family life, and various management challenges. 1.1. Method, search strategies and selection criteria. A systematic review of available literature in PubMed with the following search terms was performed: young OR, early and Parkinson, and each of diagnosis, impact, management, challenge, pregnancy, employment, prevalence and family. All abstracts were reviewed for relevance to the topic of this review. Of the 1299 abstracts reviewed, 1066 were not considered relevant to the topic of this review as the search terms were vague to capture the most abstracts possible and minimize the risk of missing a relevant study. 133 abstracts were retained and the corresponding full articles were carefully reviewed. Of these, 71 full articles were considered relevant to the topic of this review and were included. PubMed links and references from these articles were also scrutinized to identify other relevant studies as suggested by the references' titles. Similarly to the initial search, abstracts of potentially relevant references were reviewed, and, if considered relevant to the topic of this review, the corresponding full articles were reviewed. A total of 266 articles were reviewed. 1.2. Prevalence. The prevalence of PD in the Western Hemisphere has been reported to range from 130 to 200 per 100,000 in community-based studies. However, the prevalence and global burden related to PD is increasing at an exponential rate, largely due to rapidly aging population and improvement of life expectancy, with a prevalence reported as high as 2,100,000 in individuals over 80 years of age. A review of 20 epidemiological studies from Asia reported a standardized all-age prevalence from 51 to 177 per 100,000. YOPD represents 5-7% of PD patients in the Western Hemisphere, but 10-14% in Japan. It is unclear why YOPD would be relatively more frequent in Japan, but the reported data is based on retrospective chart reviews and must be, therefore, interpreted cautiously. 27. 1.3. Impact of YOPD. Young adults are more likely to be employed and have younger children and, therefore, the impact on overall productivity and prognosis is greater for YOPD than LOPD. 28. Because YOPD patients also have longer disease duration by the time they reach the age of the LOPD patients, 29, they may suffer from more physical, economic, and psychological consequences. A number of cross-sectional studies have assessed the relationship between age at onset (AO) of PD and quality of life (QOL) 6-30-34, the majority reporting an important association between younger onset and poor QOL 6-30-34. This is likely due to a variety of factors including marital conflicts, difficulties with family life, social isolation and loss of occupation 28-34. Greater worsening of QOL compared to the general population was seen in younger patients in one cross-sectional study, attributed chiefly to physical limitations and role expectation 35. Non-motor features of PD seem to have a particularly distressing impact on QOL of patients with YOPD. A cross-sectional study of 426 PD patients and 402 controls reported that YOPD AO less than 45 had a poorer QOL than LOPD AO greater than 45 and age-matched controls, probably mediated to a large degree by a more depressive mood OR 2.99 between YOPD and LOPD P less than 0.01 after adjustment for confounding factors 33. It is likely that social and psychosocial factors, including role expectations, contribute to greater impairment of QOL in young patients 34. On the other hand, younger patients usually have a greater resilience because of stronger social support with younger and healthier spouse care partner than older patients. Regarding longevity, a large retrospective U.S. study found that the survival for PD patients was 32 years in YOPD AA049, 18.5 years in middle-onset PD MOPD AO equals 50-69, and 9.3 years in LOPD AO 70-10. In comparison, median survival in U.S. males for similar age groups and around the same period was 47 years, 22 years and 9.5 years respectively, with estimated loss of years of life of 15 in YOPD, 3.5 years in MOPD and less than a year in LOPD 10. This and other studies confirm prior reports of a longer survival but greater loss of years of productive life with a younger AO 36-38. 1.4. Genetics. It has been well recognized that the younger the AO, the higher the risk of genetic predisposition 39. Indeed, a family history of PD is reported in 20% of YOPD patients versus 6.9% of LOPD patients, and the age-specific risk of PD is 7.8-fold higher in the relatives of patients with YOPD compared to 2.9-fold among the relatives of patients with LOPD 10-15. It is beyond the scope of this article to comprehensively review the genetics of PD, but we wish to highlight the most frequent causes of monogenetic forms of YOPD and their main clinical differences compared to apparent sporadic YOPD, Table 1. Park 1, SNCA, 4Q21Q23, appears to have a more rapid progression with early motor fluctuations compared to sporadic PD, 40. Furthermore, it is manifested by more severe psychiatric features, especially when caused by gene duplication 41-43. On the other hand, PARK2 PRKN 6Q26 has a slow rate of progression, but is frequently associated with some atypical features such as prominent involvement of legs, freezing of gait, dystonia, dysautonomia, sleep benefit, and marked levodopa sensitivity associated with motor fluctuations and dyskinesia 44. While these patients have less cognitive impairment 45, impulse control disorders may be more severe 46. PARK6 PINK1 1P36 also has a relatively slow rate of progression, and the clinical features overlap with PARK2 47, 48. PARK7 DJ1 1P36 is also similar to PARK2 but may be more frequently associated with blepharospasm 49. PARK 9 ATPA13A2 1P36, also known as Kufor-Rakob syndrome, is frequently associated with spasticity, dementia, ophthalmoparesis, as well as pallidol atrophy on brain imaging 50. While homozygous GBA 1Q21 mutations are known to cause Gaucher disease, heterozygous and occasional homozygous mutations in this gene have been found to markedly increase risk for PD, particularly in the Ashkenazi Jewish population 51-52. These patients tend to have a more rapid progression 53 and more severe cognitive impairment 54-58. There is some heterogeneity between the different PD-causing mutations on this gene, with severe mutations, including homozygotes or compound heterozygotes, having, compared to mild mutations, a higher PD risk 15-fold versus 3-4-fold, as well as earlier onset 59, and more severe motor and non-motor features 60. 1.5. Pregnancy. While there is no formal study on the impact of pregnancy on PD, a review of the literature reported worsening of PD-related symptoms in 31 out of 64 48% of pregnancies and improvement or status quo in 52% 61. Of the pregnant women taking medications, 83% of the total reported pregnancies, 36% worsened during pregnancy, compared to 67% of the untreated patients. This suggests that dopaminergic medications improve PD symptom during pregnancy and should be considered if the motor symptoms are troublesome. Among those who worsened and for whom details of the PD therapeutic regimen was available, only 3 out of 9 pregnancies worsened because of a decrease in medication regimen motivated by the fear of teratogenicity and are detailed here. One patient was on risagiline and pramipexole, both stopped, 62, the second was on levodopa, carbidopa, entacapone, selegiline, and ropinirole, all of which were discontinued except for carbidopa, levodopa, 63, while the third was on pramipexole which was stopped, 64. Parkinsonism worsened in 5 other pregnancies despite a stable or increased medication regimen, usually in the second and third trimester of pregnancy, 65 to 69, while it worsened 1 month postpartum in 1 pregnancy despite an increase in medication doses during pregnancy, 70. No details were available regarding changes in the PD therapeutic regimen in the other 22 pregnancies, 71, 72. A more recent series reported worsening in 5 of 14 pregnancies in PD patients. Parkinsonism worsened in 1 despite higher doses of levodopa, while the 4 others experienced transient worsening upon dose reduction that improved after subsequent dose increase. The first patient was only on pramipexole which was decreased during pregnancy, the second was on pramipexole which was decreased and risagiline which was stopped, the third one was on benzerazide, levodopa which was left unchanged and on amantadine and ropinirole both of which were discontinued, and the last patient was on a combination of pramipexole and risagiline both of which were discontinued, 73. Overall, this suggests that worsening of Parkinsonism is more likely a direct effect of the latter part of pregnancy, but can be exacerbated by medication reduction or withdrawal. The data is insufficient to suggest which agent's discontinuation is more likely to cause worsening. A common strategy seems to have been to continue levodopa if already used and discontinue other medications. Potential teratogenic effects of each agent should be taken into consideration as discussed below. In addition, pregnancy alters a woman's plasma volume, volume of distribution and metabolic state, leading to an alteration in drug's pharmacokinetics and a subsequent sub-therapeutic dosing of anti-Parkinsonian medications. Thus, anti-PD medications must be frequently assessed during pregnancy and their dosage may need to be increased to prevent worsening of PD symptoms, 74. Many animal and human observations suggest that estrogen, particularly estradiol, has a protective as well as a dopaminergic effect in PD, 18, 61, 75-84, while a smaller number suggests no benefit, 75, 85-87. Other data suggest an increased risk of PD after exposure to exogenous estrogens, 88, 89. During pregnancy, estrogen levels, particularly estriol, increase. Estriol has less affinity for estrogen receptors than estradiol, 84, 90, and, therefore, it probably plays a lesser role in modifying PD symptoms than the other hormones. Because of these inconsistent results, the role of estrogen and other female hormones in PD remains unclear. Some authors, however, observed that worsening of Parkinsonism in the latter part of pregnancy in untreated PD patients could be secondary to a decrease in estrogen's level at that period, 63, 67, and there have been anecdotal reports of worsening of PD symptoms just before and during menses, 91. Regarding the impact of PD on pregnancy, it does not seem that the disease impacts fertility, conception or the birth process in women with PD, 75. A literature review of 75 babies born to women with idiopathic PD reported only 3 fetal malformations, osteomalacia, ventral septal defect and inguinal hernia, 61. However, all of these occurred in babies born to women who were taking anti-Parkinsonian medications, namely carbidopa, levodopa, entacapone, selegiline, and benzerazide, levodopa. After reviewing the anti-Parkinsonian agents reported in each case and the outcome of pregnancy, the authors concluded that carbidopa, levodopa was the safest agent to use in pregnant women with PD, with no evidence of increased rate of teratogenicity, birth complications or miscarriages. Dopamine agonists were deemed possibly safe without evidence of any teratogenicity, though not recommended because of concern over 3.8% miscarriages and 1.3% placental abruption. Amantadine, however, showed teratogenicity and increased risk of miscarriages in many reports as well as animal studies and should not be used during pregnancy, 61, 71, 72, 92. there was insufficient data to make any recommendations regarding the safety of MAO inhibitors or COMT inhibitors during pregnancy, 61. In an additional series reporting on 14 pregnancies, dopamine agonists were used in 13 patients, levodopa, benzerazide in 4, levodopa, carbidopa, and entacapone in 1, risagiline in 7, amantadine in 4, and bipridin in 1 patient, with a combination therapy used in 9 patients. Among these, one elderly mother gave birth to a child with Down syndrome, and one sibling from a twin pregnancy exposed to pramipexole and risagiline died from unexplained liver failure. One woman had a miscarriage while on pramipexole, and there was neonatal distress when taking levodopa, benzerazide, paribidiol, and risagiline, which resolved spontaneously. No clear association between the medications and the outcomes could be established, 73. Dopamine inhibits the release of prolactin and, as such, levodopa and dopamine agonists reduce or inhibit lactation, although women have been reported to successfully breastfeed while on bromocriptine and carbidopa, levodopa, 90, 93, 94. However, data regarding the amount of medication excreted in breast milk and its impact on the infant are very limited, and breastfeeding while taking any anti-Parkinsonian medications is not generally recommended, 61, 68. 1.6. Employment is another important issue for patients with YOPD and their families, not only because of financial implications due to disability-related loss of income and early retirement, but also because of the effect on social interaction and self-esteem. Indeed, a study comparing 75 YOPD AO less than 50 and 66 LOPD patients AO 50 reported that, among those who retired, 97% of the YOPD retired early versus 73% of those with LOPD, p equals 0.00334. Other studies have found that 54% of YOPD patients retire early and 94% are likely to give up work within 10 years of disease onset, 31. Problems related to employment and long-term disability might be population-specific. One retrospective cohort review of 88 Irish patients with PD onset before age 65 years reported that unemployment rates for males were 1.6 times higher compared to the general population, but unemployment among women was not significantly affected by PD, 32. Specifically, males aged 55 to 64 years were twice more likely to be unemployed than the general population. Median retirement age was 4 years earlier in PD patients compared to the general population. The authors also found that the median time to loss of employment was 7 years, with 40% still employed after 5 years from onset, and 14% after 10 years. Early age at PD onset and early diagnosis were associated with prolonged employment, consistent with the notion of slower progression of the disease in patients with earlier onset. These findings are consistent with other studies, 8, 95-97. However, time from PD symptom onset to loss of employment was not influenced by gender, education status, type of work, manual, office, etc., hours of work, full R. Mahana and J. Jankovic, Parkinsonism and related disorders, XXX, 4X, XXXXXX, 3 time or part-time, physical demands, use of hands or mental demands of the job. Among those who were still working at the time of the study, 77% had made adjustments at work, while 67% of those who had become unemployed or who had retired as a result of PD believed that adjustments such as changes in work schedule, type of work, or having a longer time to complete tasks could have helped them to stay employed longer, 32. The challenge of staying employed with YOPD is not just related to the motor symptoms of PD. While physical disability is frequently cited as the greatest source of difficulty at work, many patients are most bothered by the perception that others might have of their impairment rather than by their impairment itself, 32. This higher level of stigma in YOPD patients, 28, can manifest as a reluctance to seek help and ask for adjustments at work, which in turn decreases the chances of staying employed. While there are no formal studies assessing it, employers need to be educated about the work changes that could be beneficial to their employees with YOPD, such as the use of occupational therapy devices, reassignment to a desk job, or more lenient deadlines, 32, 66, 97. The importance of appropriate support in the workplace has already been well established, 32, 66, 97, but does not seem to be sufficiently implemented. This requires employees and employers' awareness and education about the patient's right to have reasonable adjustments made and what resources are available to do so. Finally, depression and addictive behaviors, more frequent in YOPD patients as we will detail below, likely contribute as well to employment-related challenges. 98. Loss of earnings related to YOPD has been estimated to account for 65% of the total cost of the disease. 32. Even those PD patients who continue to work earn markedly reduced incomes. 99. The burden of unemployment from YOPD goes beyond a financial cost, including social isolation, feelings of futility, lack of purpose, and lack of daily structure. In the study by Murphy et al., 82% of those who had stopped working as a result of PD were dissatisfied with their unemployment status. Patients with YOPD are particularly likely to face financial challenges and economic strain because of decreased working capacity, loss of income due to decreased productivity at work and early retirement, and inability to advance in the workplace, as well as the cost of medications and treatment. 100. Many people with YOPD seek long-term disability because part-time employment may not provide enough income. Unemployed YOPD patients without family support face a grim future as they can become marginalized members of society and forced into low-cost housing or early nursing home placement. 101. In summary, YOPD patients carry a greater socioeconomic burden when compared with their older onset counterparts. 28, 34,102, because of the adverse impact of the disease on their financial status, which often contributes to marital conflicts, social isolation, mood disorder, sexual dysfunction, and other aspects of family life. 23, 28, 34, 1.7. Family. While no formal, controlled study has assessed the impact of YOPD on the patient's marriage and family, different authors suggest that YOPD presents an additional challenge, as many YOPD patients are only recently married and may have young children. PD can also affect sexual life, with a particularly stronger impact in younger patients. 103. Depression can decrease libido, which leads to sexual difficulties and can, in turn, contribute to or exacerbate underlying depression. In addition, bradykinesia and rigidity can interfere with movements, while sexual arousal can worsen levodopa-induced dyskinesia. 103. When present, drooling can also decrease attractiveness. Erection can also be difficult to reach and or maintain, and ejaculation can be either premature or delayed, the latter usually secondary to prescribed antidepressants. 103. Marriages or relationships of shorter duration can be more vulnerable to the strain a chronic illness can impose than those of longer duration. 104. However, younger patients usually have younger and healthier spouse, partners who can provide more support. On the other hand, YOPD patients who have young children may be concerned and have a sense of guilt for not being able to fully devote themselves to them. Finally, the higher risk of burnout in caregiver of PD patients with ICD, depression and anxiety. 105, and the higher frequency of these nonmotor symptoms in YOPD, see below, raises the concern for a higher risk of burnout among YOPD caregiver, although this has not been formally demonstrated. 105.